Welcome, yeehaw, to session 16 Savage Worlds, the Weird West, Dead in Denver, High Moon.
He's got it.
He did it.
That took so much processing power.
And I'm proud of you.
Thank you. Yeah. Hello, brothers and bells. How are you doing tonight?
Hello.
Hello.
I'm doing great.
Does anyone want any announcements they want on recording?
Big Rona has invaded my crops.
Yeah. I am currently at home with
this implies that Brenna is Jesse's crops.
I have $3.
Rude.
Nice.
Just wanted to flex.
Mr. Money
you know what that
over
means.
There.
It means I don't have enough money for chicken nugget.
Anyways, yes, welcome back to Brothers and Bells. Not Brothers and Bells, Dead in Denver.
My announcement is Bopplebee.
Thank you. Okay, before
thank you for listening. Thank you for giving me this space.
Before we get into the game, what kind of cowboy facts do we have?
Oh no.
I have a cowboy fact.
You know, I
was even reminded and I forgot to think of one.
Hold on, I have to deal Benny's out because everyone beat me. A lot of people beat me here. So everyone have your Benny for arriving on time. We will then hand out. I'm gonna count the apron. But you
thank
have to
you.
Show it off.
Well, yeah. Why else
I
would
I
own a brown
20.
Apron? No other reason.
I think I closed roll 20 by accident.
If you don't give one to me for the hat, I will put the dress on.
You're getting one for the hat, my guy.
Alright, let's go.
You should have not given him one for the hat so we could see the dress.
Exactly,
right.
Tell him he gets a bonus one for the dress.
No, Kilba doesn't want me to wear the dress. That's the thing.
KB can't deal with the huge amount of horn you get.
Mijo!
Hello!
Give me your cowboy fact.
I don't have one. Hold on.
Give me your cowboy fact.
Bo has a giant burn scar on his face. When his face got held in fire by a bully.
A bully. Oh,
bully
no.
Bad.
Yes.
Bad. Disgraceful.
Mm-hmm. All right. Go ahead, somebody. Please.
Please.
I have a cowboy fact.
What you got?
Every morning, Howie swaps the spurs on his boots. He just swaps them around for good luck.
Interesting.
Oh. Alright.
Cowboy fact. Rose loves puns. This is a fact about my cowboy.
And the character I made that doesn't do dad jokes. Damn, Ben.
Alright, I got one. Aaron lost his pinky toe to gangrene as a child.
Oh no.
His what?
Not again.
His pee-pee coat?
Pinky toe. he was never circumcised. He got gangrene and it just fell off.
Pinky toe. Get castrated, nerd.
I cannot hear you very well. I have you turned up as high as I can.
Pinky coat.
Pinky toe.
Ethan's crying.
I'm trying so hard to keep my lungs intact. You can't hit me with shit like that. You just can't.
Pee-pee goat.
That's the name of this episode.
The Brothers and Bells and
Pee-pee goat.
Anyways.
Now that we've all recovered.
Jesse.
I have a session relevant cowboy fact. Willie almost joined the Pinkertons at one point.
Oh, that'd be ugly.
Oh man, we would have had to kill you.
Yeah, they suck. Right.
Do you think you could?
I think Howie could.
I have a weapon called the bell. That's all. Thank you for listening.
That's it.
That's it. That's all.
And Ginny Brenna.
Ginny used to, she hated wearing shoes. She used to walk around the house barefoot all the time. And she was in her dad's forge workroom place one day, and she stepped on some hot coals by accident. She does not go barefoot anymore because that shit hurted.
That shit hurted.
Oh, wait, for real, for real?
She's got a big, like, burn on the bottom of her right foot, yeah.
Real shit.
Real shit.
All right, and then what kind of cowboy fact do you guys want from me? Let's pick a character.
Buzz Lightyear.
Nope.
Close enough, right? I want a cowboy fact about Chase.
Chase?
Yeah.
Chase is an enigma.
Is he a cowboy, though?
Is he? Good point.
Chase is allergic to dairy.
Oh, what the fuck?
Oh, we know how to
right, come on. This is how right, we take it down.
We've done it. Let's go. We'll sneak some cheese onto his hamburger, boy.
Slip him one of them Philly cheesesteaks.
Bro. I have a feeling it's gonna be like
get
that
him those loaded cheese fries.
He's like, where are the pickles? Like,
right. You invite him to have fondue with you.
Yes.
We get him a pet cow, and then he'll just die.
Exactly.
He'll just absorb the dairy through the cow.
Exactly. He's not allergic.
Ow! But what if?
What if he was?
Osmosis the milk.
Oh my god.
Don't you know that cows radiate dairy energy in a medium blast template?
Yep.
This is common knowledge, guys.
Exactly. Get into it.
Okay. Who wants to fill me in on what happened last session?
I love the
vampire app.
All right. So last time, all right, y'all are actually gonna let me do this? All right, I'm gonna talk for 20 minutes again.
Do it.
Y'all really about to let him do this?
All right, so last time we went to the jail. Well, not the jail. We went to the cop place.
Yes. I don't know who let
Ginny
Rose
and Rose did. My fucking hat is gone.
And snatched.
After that, we went to the crime scene. There was a guard where we learned that Chase was out with Red Fang, which was very cool. Somebody please help.
Okay, let me see.
William Bow went crime to go sneak,
and there was
Chase.
Gun missing. Pistol gone. Anti-vampire pistol. Red Fang can't touch it. Pick up with handkerchief.
The gun has very, a floral design on it.
Very proper gentleman.
Howie made a nice drawing of the pistol.
Howie also yell at Pinkertons, and they get spooked.
I have written here, we are being watched by Conway.
Kanye? I thought you said Kanye for a second.
What did Kanye do?
Kanye West.
Thank you, Kanye. Very cool.
AY.
I'm going to start calling him Kanye now. Kanye.
Always watching.
He's been
forever. Yes.
I just feel like we're glossing over the fact that Howie looked a Pinkerton agent in the eye and said, how dare you guys lose that gun?
Yeah.
And then just kept walking. What?
That is true. Was that the,
yeah, that's the biggest false play of all time.
Oh my god, dude.
Oh, I have written here, Percy said shit as we left. So like he mumbled.
Percy said shit.
Yeah.
Let Percy say fuck.
He was like shit. So
let Percy have a gun. Just kidding, he has one.
Yes. To make sure we get the full picture for everyone here. Two of you went to talk to Chase and learned that Chase is actually conversing with Conway about bringing Ghost Rock back to the city as a new supplier. While Bert Blake is managing the daily maintenance and clearing of cultists in the city in order to keep things hush-hush. Meanwhile, the other two of you went to go interviewed by Tucker and his associate.
That went
really well.
Detective Jenkins. where you then were all escorted, you all met up and were escorted to a crime scene that Tucker thought you might be interested in, where you found a dead Pinkerton, his blood sucked out from him, and a broken safe, which Howie, using witchcraft, discovered used to have a cast iron pistol in it.
Howie prefers the term warlockery.
Yeah, come on.
Afterwards, the Pinkertons arrived to cover up the scene and take over the case, in which case Howie threatened them with information he shouldn't know, and it seemed to work pretty well.
It was kind of funny. Not gonna lie.
And then you guys went home, to which Howie then started to feel awfully tired.
Right,
and upon falling asleep,
he's out for the count again.
Upon falling asleep, found himself waking up in a cast iron chamber with a dead Jedediah raised from the grave, ready to duel him with a cast iron pistol.
Yeah, I remember everything.
Yeah. Man, what's with all the cast iron?
You're inside the gun, dumbass.
Here to do some business with the cast iron. Not... Oh, wait, he is!
Oh, my God.
With the cast iron on his hip.
This is good. This is good, boys.
I love how chaotic this is beginning.
So,
crackhead energy
session. Crackhead.
Howie.
Crackhead energy. Okay. I'll post a picture in Discord.
Oh, please.
Oh, God.
Howie, you are standing there in front of a rotting corpse of Jedediah Smith, the bullet wound still in his head where you shot him last. And he says to you, well, what are you waiting for? Get up. We got a duel to do.
Oh, again? You coming back for seconds?
He paces into a stance and waits.
I'll get in my stance.
Okay. And we are now gonna go through the rules of a duel.
A 10 duel can help.
So
what?
Wow!
It's a 10
Howie,
duel
too fresh. Too, guys, guys.
Sorry.
To freshen you up on the rules of a duel, because the rules have changed a little bit in the new version of Deadlands. The duel will take place through three rounds. You will attack on round three. You start with a hole card, and every round before you fire, you can try to. You can do any action to try to give you a bonus, including testing your enemy. You can do any action except aim.
Wow.
The distracted and vulnerable stats stack and stay until the third round. as well as if you get a raise on a test, you can choose to gain a new hole card or take one randomly from your opponent, unless they only have one. On round three, you get to pick one of your hole cards to be your action card, and that will decide who wins the duel. Okay?
My body is ready.
So, we start with round one. I need to pull up Jedediah's shitty stats.
Oh no.
I forgot he has no skills.
Me IRL.
Oh no, Ben!
Okay. So, in this first round, we don't need to draw action cards because we're both technically operating at the same time. I am going to deal both of us an adventure card, or sorry, not an adventure card, a action card to, this is what will be our hole cards, which you will hold in your hand until round three.
No.
Okay. So, what do you want to do in round one?
Okay. So, would you say that flask with alcohol would be a minor mundane item weighing less than 1 pound?
Sure.
Alright. But on my first round, I'm gonna cast trinkets and pull out a flask and just drink it right in front of him. I'm just gonna throw it on the ground.
Okay. Make a spellcasting roll. He doesn't seem phased.
Okay.
But you do get your alcohol.
Alright. What I wanted.
Okay, for his action, he's going to attempt to stare you down.
Now, I get a +2 against this because I have the strong-willed.
Yes. He rolled a critical failure.
Alright. Is this spirit or smarts?
I believe
it's a critical
fail.
It's
a critical fail. You can go ahead and resist it if you want.
Yep,
this would be spirit. Okay. So since he critical failed, you get an extra hole card.
Okay.
Yeah, he tries to stare you down, but his eyes won't, like, focus on you, and one of them falls out. He's like, ah! Like, has to catch it with his offhand and put it back in.
Okay. So, for the next round, I'm gonna go off of that. Say, zombie got your eye?
Are you trying to taunt?
Solid burn.
What is this resisted by?
I don't know.
It's
resisted by smarts.
Okay, thank you. Yeah. Hazel, shut up, I'm fine! By putting his eye in. We're here to duel, not talk! He is going to... or you get to choose, do you want him to be distracted or do you want him to be vulnerable?
I want him to be distracted.
Okay. That is... 1 point of distract. So that was the second round. Round three, reveal the card you want to be your action card. King of Clubs is pretty good, but unfortunately I have you beat with a King of Diamonds.
Oh.
So close.
But now he has to hit you.
Yep. And he is distracted, if I do remember correctly.
He is distracted. So, he goes for his gun, and you try to follow up, but in a quick flash, almost identical, but his bullet leaves first as he fires at you. The skill that he's actually good in. I'm gonna Benny that.
But you don't have any Ben knees.
I'm gonna Benny that again.
Uh-oh.
Damn, dude. Going through another Benny, let's do it. There's what I wanted. There we go.
So, you see... Ah, fuck, I'll take it.
I should also let you know, I forgot to mention this one. You cannot soak wounds, yeah, during a duel. Okay. And he fires at you with the cast iron pistol.
Don't you also get an extra die of damage or something?
No, those rules have changed. He does get one extra d6 for being a card higher than yours. Never mind, you both got kings, so he doesn't get any extra damage. He gets the bonus damage from the shot. So let me remember how much damage this gun does.
2d6.
It does not do that much damage. Just more.
You threw a number out.
1.5.7 damage.
Okay.
So, I'd like to play this card right here.
Okay. This is a good thing you had that card.
Yep.
The shot fires out like a cannon. And then everything goes white. And we're going to leave that for the time being.
Without, how are we getting his turn?
No, the duel's over. For our purposes, yeah. The duel is over.
Did he win or lose? Who won?
We'll see.
Hulu.
Who won? Who's next? You decide.
Okay. Our camera fades back in from white on a wooden double doors, and we watch Tucker approach the door. U.S. Marshal Hugh Tucker approached the doors, looked towards the camera at someone unseen, and he says, "Promise me when I tell you that you are not prepared for what you're about to see in here." And he opens the door, and someone behind the counter says, "Hi, welcome to Applebee's."
Oh my god.
And the camera turns to see Ginny.
No, wait.
Hold on.
Wait, did Ginny make it home safe yesterday?
No, she went to Applebee's.
No, but did she ever come back from Applebee's?
The camera turns to Ginny during a lunch earlier in the day, when she decided to eat with Hugh Tucker.
Oh, yeah.
As he walks into the building and says, "Get me the usual table for two this time." And she leads them over to a table. And you join him and sit down.
I forgot about
they went to fucking Applebee's.
I fucking forgot we went to Applebee's. I don't remember why I decided to invite him one-on-one. I completely forgot. Oh, no.
I think it's
because
you're impulsive and you rolled poorly to not go to Applebee's.
That's true. I think that's why, actually, is because she's impulsive.
You made a don't go to Applebee's roll and you failed.
Don't we all?
Don't go to Applebee's roll.
That's usually how it goes, isn't it? That's how people end up there.
You guys sit down. Some glorious looking homemade Philly cheesesteaks are put onto the table for you, paid by Tucker.
Of course, I dive in. Because apparently this is Jenny's favorite place. Is that what I said?
It is now.
And he says, so, Miss Sudden, how long have you been in Denver?
I know this. Give me a second. Oh, about 8 years. Me and my father moved here after my mother passed away. We're here from Boston. Pretty far.
My condolences. It's hard to lose family.
Yeah. It's all right.
Oh, what about the brothers and Bells? How long have you been traveling with them?
Not very long. 6 months.
Would you say you know them well?
I know Willie pretty well. I kind of.
What about that? What about that Euchre fella?
Oh no, he's weird. Keeps to himself.
All right.
You do be kind of weird, champ.
I don't really pay him any mind, honestly.
Bro, he pissed on a vampire.
Tucker leaves that conversation for a bit aside and starts talking about just things of the city and of these sandwiches in general, and like the history of this shop being a locally grown
Applebee's. Yeah.
Towards the end of the conversation, I do enjoy having you wait for lunch with me. It was quite a swell time, and you are a wonderful little lady. And
thank you.
But I feel like I should give you some advice.
Okay. So before you say anything, I'm good at like hearing advice. Not so great at taking it, but yeah. What's up?
That Euchre fellow is a huckster.
Yeah, that makes sense.
You understand that hucksters are hunted by the law.
Yes, they
are. And I am the law.
Yes.
You don't seem very surprised by this.
No. Honestly, with this group, nothing surprises me anymore. With the things we saw down in that place, nothing really surprises me anymore. Counter question. Will I be in trouble if I am in the vicinity of him if something were to happen?
Very much indeed. I am warning you of this ahead of time, because you all seem like a good bunch. I'd hate for that to be ruined by a huckster hanging out secretly in your group.
Well, we try.
And I don't want to fill out paperwork. My job is busy enough as is.
Paperwork sucks.
So, you take this message back to that Euchre fella sometime. Tell him to get out of the city. Because if he doesn't, and if I have no good reason to stop it, then angry mobs are going to come coming for him.
Yeah, that makes sense. I'll definitely pass the message on, sir. He's kind of like me. He listens, doesn't necessarily take it, but I will definitely pass that to him.
He gets up, calls out to the person at the bar. Get whatever she wants in my tab. I'm gonna head back to work. You have a good day, miss.
Thank you, and I kind of...
The Applebee's.
And then I proceed to order 3 desserts.
Oh, Applebee's, man.
And take them with me back to the house.
Okay. We end on that little flashback as you leave the building with desserts in hand and rather foreboding knowledge that Marshall Tucker knows Howie's secret.
I probably should have concealed that a little better and not just said, yeah, sure. I should have been like, oh, you, no. No.
No, that guy never.
No.
And then he just summons things
right now. That's sinister. Right.
Okay. And we come back to the present. Someone was sleeping by Howie's side.
That was Rose.
Okay. I'd like to you guys to move yourselves into your bedrooms, like wherever you would have been sleeping for the night. Howie's on the floor, I believe, correctly. I don't think you guys moved him.
Yeah, I thought sleep here. Willie and Rose moved him up. Didn't they?
No,
I thought they did.
Oh, we
sure
did?
We did.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure I was down in my lap.
All right, Rose occupies the other bed then.
What direction is Howie facing?
Uh-oh.
What a oddly specific question.
that is
whichever direction this is. Is this north?
I would like to imply that implies that she dragged him in by his feet.
If this comes up, I do have this.
I don't think that'll come up unless something horrible happens. Okay. Howie, go ahead and make your shooting roll from the duel.
All right.
Uh-oh. Oh, no.
Uh-oh.
Oh, shit.
Okay. Howie wakes up with a start, immediately out of reflex, pulling his pistol and firing a shot straight through the door, leaving a big hole in it.
Bruh.
Rose, this wakes you up immediately. Willie, Bo, Aaron, everyone else, I need you to roll notice at -2 for you guys are sleeping.
I'm a heavy sleeper. That's one of my hindrances.
Which I believe gives you a -4 to this roll. Correct?
Yep.
Aaron be like, y'all hear something?
Because I don't.
Okay. Bo and Willie, you guys hear the gunshot. For everyone else, these are thick walls, and you guys don't hear it.
Of course.
Which is hilarious, because you told us when we moved into this house that the house has thin walls.
It depends on the weather, apparently.
Depends on the
very bad against wind, right against gunshots.
Yeah, I fell asleep.
Bo shoots up and goes running out, looking to see if he sees anything.
I am checking to make sure.
Yeah, so Howie, dying. You come to, you pulled your pistol on Jedediah, and immediately as you fired at him, you wake up with your pistol in your hand and a hole in the door. Smoke coming out of the tip of your gun.
Oh, this is awkward.
Hey,
Willie, I think there's also a hole in your door now.
Great! Cool.
Hey, Howie, you doing all right?
Oh, yeah. I was just having one of those, you know, dreams that aren't too happy. You know, I forget what they're called.
Nightmares?
Yeah. I was trying to shoot someone.
The one where you shoot the door?
I guess.
Maybe we start disarming Howie before bedtime.
Is this one of the situations where the less I know about it, the better it is for me?
I'm not too sure at this point.
All right. Well, are you safe? You seemed mighty.
I'd like to make a roll of some sort to see if I'm safe.
Roll notice.
You're already dead.
Okay, now roll occult. Okay. You look around you, you don't seem any immediate threats. However, that was the same condition when this hit you originally. Mm-hmm. So you don't know if the conditions changed.
Right,
well, you're not feeling sleepy.
I'm going to be honest with you. I am not picking up what you're trying to put down.
Whatever supernatural event just happened to you, you were already covered in your house when it happened, and you're covered in a different spot of your house. So you are physically safe, but you don't know the supernatural element of it. You don't know if things, if any terms have changed there, but you don't feel sleepy.
All right. Do I have my PowerPoint back?
No, you used that spell.
Do I see a flask on the ground?
Yes.
Holy shit. I would pick it up and drink the rest of it.
Okay. He said, oh, Pog!
Sorry, I'm on some drops in it.
Howie, after witnessing the weapon's effect firsthand, I want you to roll a common knowledge for me. Okay. You felt something similar about that pistol the first time you saw it in the flashback. But now having seen it in action, you know for certain whose pistol that is.
Oh boy.
The pistol belonged to, is called the Iron Maiden. It belonged to a gunslinger named Catherine Quinn, who was famous for hunting down hucksters and bringing them to justice.
Oh.
She did so with such success that she got the nickname Maiden Mary and was seen as a prophet sent to punish vile sinners in the name of Christ.
Let's go.
I'm not a vile sinner. I'm just your average Joe.
The last thing you know about her, she went missing 10 years ago while traveling to Elko, Nevada, chasing rumors about a Whately that was hiding in that town.
Well, I think it's time for us to go elsewhere.
Please don't ask us to go. No,
I'm going to post that information in the chat for anyone who needs to catch up on that.
Actually, I just had the most wonderful idea.
Went to Nevada.
All right. What's your idea, Howie?
About a week.
All right, so I'm thinking, what if for like a couple months or so, I just like dress up as a different person? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Will that work against vampires?
I mean, after we solve the vampire problem, you know, we could change my name to Showered.
Aaron, at this point, there's enough conversation going on upstairs that you can choose to wake up if you would like.
I would not like to wake up.
Okay.
Same.
John,
me every day.
Jenny's in the basement. She doesn't hear a damn thing.
Oh, yeah. How dark is it outside? What time?
I'm sleeping in a doorway. Thank you.
You're starting to see a brief hint of sunlight starting to come up.
Okay. All right. Well,
make a notice roll as you look out to see what time of day it is.
All right.
That was a really good notice roll.
It's 5 a.m.
It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
As you look out to see the sun,
you notice in the alleyway someone holstering a pistol and walking into the alleyway. And the only detail you catch out with a raise is a white cowboy hat and a white suit.
Bruh.
It's Bud Lightning.
Holy shit. Buzz Lightyear. Wait a minute.
And at the same time, as he walks away, you notice, we're going to say your window, you can see like the street a little bit. You see several black suited individuals with bowler hats making their way towards your house.
Uh-oh.
They're carrying serious gunfire. Or firepower. That's the word I'm looking for.
Is our house being...
Hey, you should probably tell somebody about that.
So, we're about to get robbed.
Alright, so there's some Pinkertons coming, or as they may be more well-known, Stinkertons.
Alright, so, I'll go talk to them, see what they want.
Not here. I've been out on the town, you know. Yep. Alright.
Yep.
Howie's gonna go take his blankie and like get in his bed and just
good night.
You're gonna hide under the bed.
Do you want to pull a stealth action for me?
I would.
Good night.
Okay, what?
Bro, he has blankied so good.
You feel very hidden.
Okay. That's like the equivalent of pulling your covers up when there's a murderer in the house.
As Howie starts to hide himself. You guys have one round to react before the Pinkertons reach around your house.
Ginny's asleep.
Rose is gonna go down to the door.
I have a question.
What's up?
On a scale of 1 to 10, how dressed are we?
How
long
does it
take
you
to put some armor on and to grab a sword?
Armor would take a while. All right, depending
so
on the armor.
He grabs a sword, but he's not armored. Let's go.
Do I have time to put clothes on, or do I have to answer in my PJs?
I mean, if you could put clothes on in 20 seconds.
I would like to wake up and start making my way to the basement.
I'm gonna make an agility roll to see how well I put clothes on.
Okay.
Throwback to the first session, boys.
Very good. I put on clothes very well.
Did it take Rose like 3 rounds to put her clothes on after that bath?
Rose, you probably have been training after that.
She's been
That's
practicing,
good. That's
dude.
Good.
She's not going to be caught with her pants down this time.
Yeah, but Rose, if you took your armor off, you would definitely not have time to put it back on.
Oh yeah, I'm not talking armor. I'm just talking like a nice hastily put on dress or pants or something.
Before Rose leaves the room to go get dressed, Howie's gonna be like, Howie ran off with the circus.
All right, nice.
If anybody asks.
Okay, Aaron, are you going to wake up Ginny? Is that what your plan is down there?
Possibly.
She's asleep.
Yeah. Okay. I passed out at my workbench in full. She just didn't go to bed, and then she fell asleep. So she's already dressed and ready to go, sort of. Besides the fact that she's asleep.
Wake my flock up.
Okay. The reaction is waking up the flock. Okay.
You're gonna wake up the flock before you wake me up.
Look, they're closer, so they can then spend their action to go to you. Nah, come on.
Mm-hmm. Or a heavy sleeper.
I am.
Just one person might not be enough.
Ginny, since he's waking up the flock, go ahead and roll a nose roll at -4 to wake up. No, ma'am.
Big sleep.
Big sleep.
Big sleep time, boys.
Just like pass up. Better guess.
Okay.
There's papers everywhere.
So, you all hear calling out from in front of your house. a familiar voice of Mr. Percy Yates yell out, "Brothers and bells! By the power of the Pinkertons, I order you to turn over your friend Howie Euchre Whateley for questioning and containment."
He's not here. Try somewhere else. Maybe the bar or the gambling house.
Do you check outside to do that? Like, do you look out the door for that?
Yelling out
or you
the
just yell? Yelling through the window. So you can, with a vision of seeing Percy Yates outside the front door, you see Percy along with Alan William, his partner, along with about 10 Pinkerton agents who have set up barricades and are behind a barricade with their Gatling pistols and revolvers. Or revolvers and carbines, I think.
Why, Mr. Percy? Although Bo may have been rather crude about it, Howard Whateley isn't here at the moment. Last night he muttered something about being scared of something or other and ran out. He has not come back yet, at least to my knowledge. You're welcome to search if you wish, though.
Make a deception check. Persuasion check.
Britain.
Can I assist because of the thing?
Did you say
yes.
Persuasion?
I yelled for
persuasion.
Wow, I would like.
I get one free reroll.
I have six. All right. I might as well Benny that.
I'm going to use ace to succeed with one raise.
Yeah, wow, I'm so good at this.
Bruh.
I might as well keep going. Fuck it.
I don't know how this affects because he has to. I guess it means it's 8 is your total because he has to contest it.
Oh.
And I assisted for one more, right? For plus 2?
Yeah. Yes. So that becomes 9.
Yep.
Okay.
Quick question. Would he find me attractive?
No.
Yeah, man. He's probably gay thinking about it.
This man is attracted to his work, nothing else.
Goddamn sapiosexual.
Okay. Then I must ask that you all come out of your house with your weapons down, so that we may take you in for questioning and containment as well.
May I ask what I've done, sir?
Your friend is connected to the supernatural, either through huckster means or other means. It is in your best interest that he be protected with us before the law gets to him.
Oh shit, I'm still asleep.
With all due respect, I don't think anybody can take better care of Howie than Howie himself.
Ginny, at this point, a member of the flock attempts to wake you up. Go ahead and make a nose roll, no penalty.
At this point, Howie would walk down. Avoiding windows, of course.
Okay. Yeah, Ginny, you wake up. You hear a booming voice echoing through the house from outside of Percy Yates.
Oh shit, is it that Luke Gates guy? I like get up and I start running up the stairs. My shit's going down and I'm missing it. FOMO.
FOMO.
I mean, I will come with if you wish. I don't mean to cause any trouble or violence.
Hey, Percy.
Oh my lord.
Well, now we're liars.
Oh my lord.
I am not a liar because I said I don't believe he's come back yet.
Which is true because I never left.
Yep. I specifically left wiggle room in there for if he didn't show up.
I decided he's not here.
Howie, where are you yelling from?
I came down.
Okay, move your token.
Oh, shit, right.
You know, we have like a secret room. We could have hid you.
I'm avoiding windows, and I don't see any windows, right, so I'm just gonna put myself, like, here. I'm gonna go, hey, Percy! How about we settle this like men? You and me.
Rose would like to visibly jump and be like, oh shit, he is here.
Oh shit.
As if she got like jump scared from him yelling behind her.
Interesting. Make a persuasion or taunt?
I am good at neither of those.
Yay.
Use a Benny. Use a Benny. I don't care anymore.
Okay, still have to contest it. Okay. Percy says, I'm honored for the offer, Mr. Waitley, but knowing your family's honor, as well as the honor of hucksters and you, or the honor of spellcasting individuals and how they have already tainted the natural order of the world, I'm not expecting you to uphold the order of tradition.
I don't think it's very honorable of you to be talking about my honor when I have never once cheated a duel.
I'm not saying you have, I'm just saying I don't trust you or your kind.
All right, now that honorable means are off the table. Bye.
One quick.
You didn't think this ahead, did you?
Howie, I need you to make us. Howie, I need you to make a stealth roll for me. Okay.
Unfortunate.
Rip.
So, at this point, I'm gonna go down to the basement.
How we get 11 on a d10 without exploding?
He's not doing anything right at this moment.
He is doing something. The moment you say bye, you hear him say, let him have it. And a cacophony of gunfire goes off at the front door.
Fuck it.
All right, Rose G is just dying here, I guess.
Right, Rose and Howie, I need both of you to make evasion rolls for me.
Am I really fucking unskilled in this?
It is agility minus 2.
While this is happening, can Bo have been climbing onto the roof stealthily?
Want to Benny this?
Out of his window?
Sure. Sure.
Hey. Killbud, I remember there being like some sort of hole from the basement that leads out that is like very small.
I'll take
There was a small crack in the ceiling, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, isn't it right here?
Yeah. I mean, that's the poop hole, but it's next to it.
Oh.
Boy, I love me a shithole.
Yep.
Okay. You both start diving for cover. Rose, you immediately dive to this table and like push it over, and as the bullets start raining through, Howie, you dive over the bar and like hide behind it, bullets flying through. I think it hurts Willy the most that we hear all of the alcohol shattering as bullets fly through them.
No.
And we are going to enter combat, but first we're going to take a break because we're a TV show.
Yeah.
I don't have anything
right after these
commercials.
Right after
I didn't
these
have my knife
fence knees. There's five of them. please use them wisely.
Ooh, baby. No, bud,
can I send you a picture of my literal knee to get a Benny in game, please?
Nope.
Okay.
Yeah, we will be back later. Stay tuned.